Hi, welcome. We're going to discuss the impact of multiple Office 365 data centers on your teams and Office 365 data. My name is Sigi, and today with me is...
Yeah, hi, I'm Tom.
Yeah, so Tom, we talked about this before, yeah, and you told me that you didn't know that Office 365, the German version, yeah, so the... that it's that for a year now.
Yeah, I didn't know that. So Microsoft have lots of what they call go local data centers around the world, but Germany used to have, I now know, a version run by T-Systems, an independent version.
An isolated, completely isolated version.
And they have the same in China, which I think still exists, the 21 VNet version.
Yeah.
But yeah, the Germany version of T-Systems is no more, apparently.
Correct. You can still use it, but you're not able to apply new tenants on it.
Right.
However, most recently, Microsoft announced the German data centers, yeah, and also several other data centers around the world, like South Africa, like South Korea.
Yeah.
I read your blog. Yeah, you announced that. Yeah, yeah. So, what's your point of view when they open a new data center? You told me first it's Azure. Correct?
Yeah, and it's really interesting. This is quite unique to Microsoft because they have the Azure business and the Office 365 business. They can invest in all these local data centers.
Yeah.
So if you're in my space in Microsoft Teams, if you're a competitor vendor, it wouldn't necessarily make sense for you to build a data center dedicated to collaboration in South Africa, but absolutely it makes sense for Microsoft to build a data center for Azure and the whole of Office 365 because they're serving that region. So what we're seeing is Microsoft just put tons of investment in these local data centers, but to your point, they're different. So some of them are just for Azure, some of them are for Azure and Office 365, and some of them are for Azure Office 365 and actually having Teams data local as well.
So you were saying Office 365 core services such as Exchange and SharePoint, that comes first. And Teams comes later.
Yeah, usually that's the case. Because Teams runs on lots of different microservices, it's not one monolithic product they deploy in the data center. Yeah. So they have to run instances of those microservices in region to keep your data local. So I think it comes based on customer demand. If lots of customers, and typically it tends to be government customers, healthcare, any reason, I mean, you know, Germany is very tight on data being in country borders.
Data was, yeah.
So any countries that have that kind of tight requirement tend to get local services first.
Yeah, it's like Switzerland, yeah? There's also a data center announced in Switzerland.
Yeah, yeah, again, like the financial services there, very much data in borders is important to them.
However, the main difference to Black Forest or the German cloud is that it's part of the global Office 365. Yeah, so it supports full collaborative work. It supports all the features immediately. Yeah, more or less immediately.
Yeah, yeah.
Because they roll out in. But it's a real benefit, correct?
Yeah, you're still getting all the features of Office 365. But if you nominate to go to a local data center, be aware of what's available in that data center. And as you say, you will see a lag on features because they tend to go out to regions first, then into the go locals.
And I heard this, it's also a problem to move the data between data centers, yeah? Especially if it's possible at all. Well, of course, but what's your experience with that?
Yeah, it can be challenging. So usually when services launch in local data centers, new tenants can elect to be there from day one. If you want to move your data from a region to a go local, you have to have a support ticket with Microsoft, have various conversations. Yeah. It depends on what workload you're using, depends on how much data you have. There's no magic button to click to just jump all your data from one data center to another. It is a project.
And it takes a long time, I heard.
Yeah? It can do, yeah. It's
and some data might not move at all.
No. It depends whether the individual services you use in Office 365 support taking the data. And again, we've talked about on a previous video about how it's tricky to move data for Teams. So that's one of those workloads where you should engage with Microsoft if you need local support.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Okay, so I think that's an important topic to consider.
Yeah, yeah? Definitely. I think
so. The key takeaways is if you're right now in a tenant, it will take anyway a long time, like half a year or a couple of months at least, to move that to a new data center if that shows up. So make sure you talk to Microsoft regularly and see if there's something changing.
Yeah, if you have this requirement, your business will know about it because you probably were already talking about it. So absolutely, engage with Microsoft early, talk about what workload you're using and consider it a project. It's not a button you can push. And when you build a new tenant, make that decision carefully first.
Yeah.
Don't just build the tenant then decide because moving later is harder.
Correct. Moving later is not even harder, it's a nightmare.
Yeah, non-trivial.
No, I totally agree. Thanks, Tom.
Great, thank you.